Hi everyone, I'm Marcello La Rosa, Professor of Information Systems at the University of Melbourne and the CEO and co-founder of Apromore. I would like to thank Matthias Weidlich and Ernest Teniente for their invitation to participate in this virtual panel on the topic of privacy in data-driven process analysis. More chance or risk for industry adoption? So Matthias and Ernest came up with a few questions, and what I'd like to do in this few minutes is to go through these questions and provide my own viewpoint. So first one is, do you think that privacy risks have always been around data-driven operational analysis, or does process mining create new challenges? More than bringing about new challenges, I think that with process mining, privacy becomes more relevant. And that is because with process mining, it is easier to expose the actual business operations, the naked reality of an organization, so to say. You know, with process mining techniques such as automated discovery, we can automatically reverse engineer the activities that are performed within the context of a business process. And the handoff of work between resources that perform such activities. So it is easier and faster to expose information that might be confidential, sensitive information about customers or about the resources on performance, for example, identifying resource bottlenecks, underutilized or overutilized resources. So more than bringing about more challenges, actually, the topic of privacy becomes more relevant because it's faster to gain access to disclose sensitive information. It's faster and easier. Second question, which domains do you consider to be particularly relevant for privacy management? In our experience with Apromore, we've got privacy concerns being raised mostly by organizations that operate in two domains. One is by the financial domain, so banks, insurance, superannuation companies, as well as fintech companies like credit clearance check organizations. And on the other hand, organizations that operate in the healthcare domain. So for the first sector, clearly, you can gain access to information about the financial matters of clients, such as their payment transactions, their lines of credits, their debts, basically their financial situation. So you understand that if this information ends up in the wrong hands, you can make a lot of damage with that. So clearly, financial organizations prefer to be very conservative and try to protect themselves by even questioning the utility of process mining against the risk of information leak. Likewise, in the healthcare domain, you can gain access to the medical condition of patients, the diagnosis, their treatments, their discharge information, etc., etc. And again, that is quite sensitive information. Third question. Privacy considerations may relate to internal process providers, such as employees, process stakeholders, as well as external clients, customer, patients. How do you see the importance of these two perspectives? Well, we've already talked about the latter perspective, the importance of customer sensitive information, such as patients in the healthcare domain. Likewise, I mentioned it when I answered the first question, it is also about the internal resources of an organization. For example, gaining an understanding of resource performance. Who is the fastest? Who is the slowest? Who is the most overloaded employee? What are the handoffs of work between resources that are the smoothest versus those that are clogged, and why? But also, who are the resources that tend to violate in a systematic way a certain compliance principles, such as compliance rules, such as a 4I principle, right? So for example, a financial officer that raises an invoice should be different than the financial voices that authorizes that invoice for payment. With process mining, with tools like Apromore, you can flip the perspective from an activity-centric process map, where basically each node in the graph is an activity, to a resource-centric map, where each node in the graph basically represents a resource, a role, or any other organizational structure. Hence, what you're discovering is the social network of interactions between those resources. So you can easily pinpoint, when you overlay performance statistics such as duration, you can easily pinpoint resources that are working very slow, so that they become a bottleneck for this process. Resources that are overutilized when you overlay frequency information, etc., etc. Likewise, you can look for compliance violations and go down to the level of the individual resources that violate, and with what frequency, certain compliance rules. So certainly, you can disclose some sensitive information there that relates to the internal employees and process stakeholders. So the performance of a team versus the performance of another team. And it boils down to the process owner for that process, or the team leader, who are accountable for the performance of the respective teams. So definitely employees and other process stakeholders. Privacy considerations in process analytics so far received little attention by tool vendors. Do you expect this to change? And how will privacy considerations influence the process analytics market? A push for in-house solutions or for specialized external consultants? Can it be a threat for process analytics projects? I guess, in our experience, it boils down to trust. In our experience with Apromore, from a process mining vendor viewpoint, privacy and confidentiality of information are more a matter of perception, perceived risk, than a technology issue. It's not about what privacy-enhancing technology we can use, because, you know, if the process mining user could be reassured that there is a particular technology that would absolutely protect their data, you know, we would go there, implement the technology, and that's it, tick the box and move on. No, unfortunately, the problem is the perceived risk of a process mining software exposing sensitive information. So it's more a governance problem than a technology issue. And in those domains, healthcare, the financial domain, the answer from managers is to cut short and go for on-premise deployment. They say, look, you can show me that you are compliant with whatever security standard, you know, ISO 21001. But at the end of the day, our customer data must remain on-premise. And even hybrid deployments, where the data stays with the client and the algorithms run in the cloud, where you have access to more powerful resources, is not acceptable. They prefer everything to remain locally. And the problem with those solutions is that clearly they are less flexible, because deployment and maintenance of the process mining product has to go through their IT staff. So it is slower, it might be more cumbersome, and you are somehow penalizing or diminishing the benefits, the flexibility of having a process mining solution on the cloud. But the problem there is not showing them that we are using this or that technology. It's really the perceived risk of information leak, of privacy violation. So basically the lack of trust. And this lack of trust has become so ingrained in the mindsets of managers in certain domains that they don't even think about it. They don't even want to discuss. They say, look, that's great. We like the tool. And you offer both options. We're going to go on-premise, period. Likewise, if you try and push for certain technologies like differential privacy, then on the other extreme, the question in the mind of these managers would be, okay, how do you guarantee me that privacy is being protected, but this is not to the detriment of accuracy, so the so-called utility? How do you ensure that the analysis results are trustworthy? So basically, when we entertain discussions related to technology that can ensure privacy by design, then these questions typically arise. What I think that is missing, so, is not yet another technology, but rather a clear set of guidelines that can show to managers how a given process mining software is compliant with certain privacy preserving regulations, such as the GDPR in Europe, or the Californian Consumer Privacy Act in California, or here in Australia we've got the Australian Privacy Act. How can we ensure that the software has been designed in such a way to systematically comply with a given privacy preserving regulation? And it's great to see new technologies popping up from time to time as track one and track two papers in the BPM conference. But really what I don't see is track three paper, management papers that indeed come up with guidelines on how to ensure compliance with relevant regulation. And this doesn't have anything to do with security. Being certified for, you know, ISO 21001 or other security frameworks provide just the building blocks, but they do not per se guarantee that privacy is preserved. We need to really map certain functionality of the software with privacy preserving regulations such as the GDPR in Europe. So my invite to the BPM research community is to work on interdisciplinary research at the intersection between computer science and information system on the one end, because we still need to build a tool and this tool needs to be useful for analysts and managers. But on the other end, we need lawyers, we need experts in the relevant regulations. So this is, to me, the challenge that process mining vendors are facing: how to demonstrate systematically and in an ambiguous way that the software has functionality that can preserve privacy by design. It's not a matter of technology, right? It's really how can we win the trust of managers, especially in those domains such as healthcare and finance, where sensitive data is the centerpiece of the analysis. All right, next question. Where in the traditional BPM lifecycle do you see a need to incorporate privacy aspects? Well, if you look at data-driven analysis techniques like capabilities coming from process mining, you see that process mining offers contributions to at least three phases of the life cycle: to the discovery through automated process discovery capabilities, to the analysis phase by providing a range of quantitative analysis techniques, and definitely to the monitoring phase, e.g. with techniques from predictive process monitoring. So clearly, those three phases of the BPM lifecycle, discovery, analysis, and monitoring, are three phases where privacy concerns become very important when you employ process mining techniques as part of this phase. And the final question is, how do you value the impact of the trend to incorporate more and more diverse data sources, such as sensed data for process analytics? I think this is more of a general question. It's not necessarily specific to privacy. What we've observed with Apromore in our practical experience is that organizations, as they reach higher level of process mining maturity, then they tend to extend the analysis from isolated process fragments to end-to-end value chain. So from order to cash all the way to lead to cash. So lead to quote, quote to order to cash, like three processes in a row. And as such, chances are that these processes would be supported by more than one enterprise system. E.g., a meter to cash process at a utility company may be supported both by a CRM and an ERP system, as far as the metering and the invoicing parts of the system, of the process, sorry, are concerned. So as such, we need to extract, transform, and load multiple sources in order to generate a single consolidated event log that then can be used as input to process mining tools. So if you wish, privacy challenges get magnified as you operate over larger and more varied data sets. But this is more, to me, a challenge related to ETL, to the ETL pipeline, than necessarily a specific privacy challenge. So how can we provide techniques that can help us perform ETL pipelines in a way that doesn't necessarily require technical expertise? So this is something that we are facing, for example, with Apromore, and we have an ETL tool that can help analysts perform some of these operations through drag and drop or user interfaces, so without the need to write scripts. All right, thank you very much for your interest, and I hope you enjoy the BPM conference. Bye for now.